Hello everybody. So today is Thursday, I believe. I first started experimenting with Neovim for Rust last Saturday. So yeah, gradually adding more and more features, trying to get up to where I want to be with it. So today we're going to look at ligatures. And ligatures on Linux Mint, I know, Linux Mint, sorry, I should be using Arch Linux. Not supported with the terminal as by default. So what do I mean by terminal? The standard terminal emulator, this one. So what's it called? Was it GNOME Terminal 3.360? As of September or late August 2023, not supported ligatures. But they are supported with tabby.sh. So I just want to quickly run through tabby.sh. I've only started installing it or using it an hour ago, but yeah, it looks really nice. So, download link there, features, GitHub, blah, blah, blah. If you go down to, well, rather, if you go to the GitHub page, scroll down to, you just need to go past the nice demo, Tabby, a terminal for a more modern age. Just come down a bit and you've got Debian Ubuntu based. Click on that and it brings you to packagecloud.io. And then you've got deb rpm node python gem and you can do a quick install. So if you run this, copy that, then you paste that into your existing, i.e. the GNOME terminal, run that and that'll add the PPAs that you need. Once you've got those, then you can go ahead and you can then do your sudo apt get install tabby, or you can just download the tabby install package from, let me show you. So you could just then go and download it from, sorry, this is my computer's not very quick when it's recording, but you could download it from here, and then you just use the package installer install software. Yeah, software manager. Which, to be honest, if you just download the installer, you could just get it, but you could just right click on it from your folder. Anyway, installing is quite specific to your own distro. So really, I just wanted to just show you that even on a six-year-old Dell laptop with, I think it's 8 gigabytes of RAM. The one caveat with this is it says don't use it for the low RAM, but I'm guessing that really is if you're on a Raspberry Pi or something. So what I've also done is just set up, I don't know if I set them up or if they're existing, if it's copied them over from existing, I can't remember, but F11, that takes it full screen. So yeah, full screen, so there we go, and we're running, I know I did WQ, I normally do control ZZ. So yeah, then we got ligatures. What else have we got? We got the fat arrow pointer as well. So yeah, there you go. I hope that's been useful and just proven. It's always nice to see a current video or a current article actually confirming that something works before you invest time looking at it. So this is pretty neat. This is, VS Code is great for doing HTML and stuff, but just the capabilities of having the Vim key bindings and the Vim macros and so on and so on. I don't need to teach you about Vim. So anyway, that is how I got ligatures working with NeoVim for doing some Rust programming. Thanks for watching.